Welcome to Safety and Health in Engineering, Unit 3.2, Job Hazard Analysis, JHA. A job hazard analysis, JHA, identifies every procedure or step and the hazards related to each step of the task. It is also defined as listing a job or task into specific steps, analyzing each step for specific hazards, creating safe work procedures to eliminate or reduce the identified hazards, and integrating safe work procedures into safety and health training and programs. In order to ensure all workers are safe at all times, a JHA must be developed for each job or task. The supervisors and the workers are the best suited to develop a JHA as they are the task implementers. They can list and identify each step of the task and identify the hazards of each procedure, which results in effective and efficient suggestions to control and handle the hazards. There are 6 steps used as guidelines by the Department of Occupational Safety and Health to formulate a job hazard analysis. Step 1. Select the work or job task to be analyzed. Prioritize the job task with the most accidents, injuries, hazardous zones because they have the highest potential for serious injury or death. This step is applied when a new task or procedure of new processes is developed, as each task creates its own unique hazards which needs different treatment or procedures. Step 2. Identify the major sequence of steps for each step. Once a job task has been identified, the task is broken down into logical steps. Number of steps should be limited to a manageable number to ensure workers are able to follow the procedures properly. The job steps must be kept in sequence to ensure a proper analysis. Step 3. Identify the potential hazards for each step. Once the steps have been chosen, the potential hazards for each step will be identified. There may only be one question for each step, or at times there may be a large number of questions for each step, especially when dealing with hazardous or biological hazardous material. Examples of questions to guide the implementation of this step are as follows. What can go wrong or may go wrong? What are the potential hazards of each step? Where is the hazard when the workers are completing the task? Is the worker exposed to hazardous chemicals? Are the workers exposed to hazardous chemicals upon completing a given task? Is the workers subject to poor workstation design? Step 4. Determine preventive measures to protect against hazards. It is very important to determine the preventive measures to control or eliminate the identified hazards. Suggestions and recommendations of actions to be taken to control or eliminate the hazard are implemented in this step. The steps of determining and assigning preventive measures using the hierarchy of control are: eliminate the hazard, substitute with less hazardous substance or material. This changes the hazardous level and minimizes the hazardous control severity. Next, contain and enclose the hazard. Use a fume hood or proper shielding to limit the exposure of hazard or to confine the available hazard. Next, revise safe work procedures. Add additional steps to enhance safe work procedures. Reduce worker exposure. This is the least effective option in most cases, but may have to be used when permanent work process change is impossible or impracticable. Examples: job rotation and using personal protective equipment, PPE. Going back to the job hazard and analysis step 1 to 6, step 5 is to develop a worker training program. Reformat the job hazard analysis into a training program to help employees eliminate or reduce hazards. And the final step, step 6, re-evaluation. Re-evaluate the job descriptions and modify the job hazard analysis accordingly. That's all for this subunit. Up next, we will have risk assessment as a topic.